couple return to their big palatial 80s house, where Don gets the chance to show off the job he did emotionally sanitizing their personal effects.
Where are the old ones, Don? And the pictures?
In the garage. Picked out most of this stuff while you were in the hospital.
Not this one.
Didn't want doctors and nurses to know everything I had.
Nice touch. Their first night home together, Don manages to firmly shove his foot in his mouth a couple of times.
That sounded just like you. I'm sorry, that was...
Just before he firmly manages to snuggle a bit. However, awakened by a feeling of unease, Julia gets up during the night to notice a strange car passing by the neighborhood. Assuring Julia that it's nothing, Don convinces her to return to bed, where, shortly afterwards, and for the first time since her accident, they engage in quote-unquote snuggling. Still feeling out of sorts, Julia makes a trip to consult with the brain trust at the hospital the next day, spotting the mysterious car again on the way out. Dr. Gordon is dismissive, if sympathetic, providing some words of advice and reflection.
Information from the body is blocked from reaching the cortex, and this can lead to feelings of panic, of paranoia, persecution. I suspect that that's the problem here, and it'll pass. As the nerve pathways reroute themselves.
Yep, typical female scrambled brainedness. It's in the Lancet.
I mean, my whole life before revolved around my looks, my image. Now I don't know what to do with myself.
Yeah, it's not like you have the looks of a successful actress or anything. Bam! Ha ha ha! Seriously, though, that's a genuine concern. You have my sympathies. Cadaver body.
Is it possible that your marriage was based on your image, too?
I don't know anymore. I don't even know who's Julia.
Somewhat ungrammatical title drop.
You are Julia.
She then pays a visit to good old Doc Matthews.
Julia, what are you doing?
Oh, Matt. Well, I was coming to see you. I miss you.
You come to my office.
This is probably the only movie where a brain transplant expert says that to a patient where there are no witnesses around and there aren't horrific consequences.
You don't trust me?
It's not you I don't trust.
See? He agrees with me, too.
Well, I don't trust anyone. I don't. The only time I'm not scared is when I'm with you. I've lost control over my life. The surgery without my permission. People telling me what to do, telling me where to go, how to feel. And the less control I have, the less I know who I am. I'm not even allowed to love who I want, am I? That is how little control I have.
And who is it that you want to love?
I don't know. Don. You.
And why me? You think?
Aside from the fact that you're extremely handsome, you have a sensational bedside manner, and you saved my life.
No. Think like a doctor. You've been around them enough.
Because I've grown dependent on you.
Being totally dependent upon another person is not living. And it's not love.
Probably the undertone message of the whole movie here. Aside from chopping people's brains out is A-OK as long as you keep a level head about you.
For months, Don was terrified that he would not be able to love you in another body. Now, Gordon and I told him to give you a chance, and he did. He stood by you, and he pulled you through. Now it's your turn.
Can I ask you one thing?
Sure.
Why do you love me?
I'm into freaks. After an awkward and oversensitive trip to visit Don's latest photo shoot, we check back with Saucy Jackie being slightly creepy.
Speak well to me. Daddy's bringing Mommy home.
And then back to Don finding Julia being very slightly creepy.
What are you doing?
I found it in the garage.
Don't do this to me. Take it off.
You say that as if it doesn't belong to me.
It's just... it's sick. It's morbid.
I left those on your mummy for months.
Let me never call me Julia.
The reason I never call you Julia anymore is because the
this
only
escalates into a bit of a tiff. Don storming off, and Julia a short while later going to dump a dead supermodel's clothes in a landfill in the middle of the night.
I love technical half-truths. They sound so delightfully awful on paper.
But, hilariously, she's soon approached and boxed in by the mystery car. Guess who's driving?
You all right in there? Need help?
My car is stuck. I'm tired. I just want to go home.
Sure. I'll take you home, Mary Frances.
Though for a shocking swerve, it turns out Jack just wants to talk. Albeit talk about how she's really Mary Frances, and if she just comes home to talk to little Timmy, she'll be able to search her feelings and know it to be true.
For Timmy's sake. And then if you want to leave, you tell him you have to go away forever, and then you can leave. I promise. No strings.
Whether it says more about her emotional state or the quality of the script, she actually agrees.
Jim?
Mommy? Mommy!
Nice. And now, slicing someone's brain out has become the least cruel, inhumane thing someone's done in this flick.
Jack attempts the old family album memory stirrer gambit. Ah, nice shirt. Don't even have to make a joke.
Aren't you gonna paint a smile on his face?
What do you mean?
The way he used to.
Unfortunately for him, it becomes increasingly apparent that this is all for naught. Jack, however, refuses to accept it.
Jack.
Please, baby. Let things be the way they used to. Don't let them change you.
Jack, no. Please stop it.
You can want me. You want me. I know you do. I can feel it.
Stop it!
Attempted rape in a Lifetime movie. Take a shot.
Luckily, Julia knocks some sense into him. Quite literally.
Worked.
Note to self. Amends made and lacerations patched, Julia makes her goodbyes to Jack, and Jack his goodbyes to Mary Frances.
Oh, lady. Are you sure? I know you felt something when you held Timmy. And when I held you, I know you did.
This body felt something. I don't understand it either. But I know I'm not your Mary Frances. I am Julia North.
What about being a mother to Timmy? He doesn't know the difference, can't you be?
You still don't want to give her up, do you? She's dead, Jack. She's gone.
Oh, lady. I understand cars. I sure understand cars.
To go now, Timmy.
No!
But your mommy wants you to know that she loves you so very much. And she always has. And she always will.
Finally returns home, into the arms of Don, who's been up fretting after having his own soul-searching rap session with the surgeons, which I've mostly skipped over because they're tasteful and more boring than watching CSF dry, and the two ride off into the credits.
So that was Who is Julia? A surprisingly, and for any movie, not just a Lifetime movie, thoughtful, non-sensationalistic, and non-stupid movie about human brain transplantation. And one of very few that I can think of that doesn't include at least one intentional murder or someone being burned to death by the end. But it has a very important moral. That is, radical experimental advances in medical science are perfectly fine. It's just that most patients are whiny, hysterical idiots who won't appreciate your efforts, so maybe you shouldn't bother helping them. This has been Mad Science Minutes. Our next episode, either Frankenstein, The True Story, or 10 Best Clips of Animal Testing. Number 10, Goat and Pigeon Being Exposed to Nerve Gas. Until next time...
Autumn shades come tumbling down. Julia, winter leaves the branches bare, and icy breeze.